Shut up.
Where's all of my praise at? I want everybody around the world to put your hands together, because all the praise belongs to God. Here we go. It's who I got. Every word of worship. With one accord. Every praise. Every praise.
To our God.
Come on, everybody, sing hallelujah.
Sing hallelujah.
To our God.
Glory, hallelujah.
It's to our God. Come on, say every praise.
Every praise.
Say every praise.
Every praise.
It's to our God. Y'all know how we do it. Take it up and praise.
It's
to our God. Every word of worship. With one accord. Come on, say every praise.
Every praise.
Is to our God. I want everybody all over the world to sing hallelujah. To our God. Glory, hallelujah.
Is
to our God. Every praise.
Every praise.
Is to our God. Let's take it up one more time. Every praise. Come on, everybody. Every word of worship. With one accord. Every praise.
Every praise.
It's to our God. I don't care how you're feeling right now. Sing hallelujah. To our God.
with a bang. Y'all ready? Hands up, real quick.
Working for my good, yeah, cause he's intentional, never failing. I know that all things are working for my good, yeah, cause he's intentional, never failing. All things are
working for my good.
Intentional.
He's intentional.
Hey, and he's never failing.
Never failing.
All things are working
for my good.
He's intentional.
He's intentional.
He's never failing.
Never failing.
All things are working.
All things are working
hey,
for
I
my
that
good.
All things are working for my good. Yes, they are, yeah.
I
know that all things are working for my good.
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 Cause he's intentional.
He's intentional.
That's it. Say so he's intentional.
He's intentional.
He's never failing. Thank you, God. Cause he's intentional.
He's intentional.
Never failing.
Never failing.
They can say that all things are working for my good. Yes, they are. He's intentional. Yeah. Never failing. Say that out. Say
all things are working for my good.
Hey, and he's never failing.
Never failing.
All things are working for my good.
Hey,
all things are working for my good.
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 All things are working for my good. It's working for me, yeah, it's working for me, yeah, and I believe it's working for me. I can smile again, and I don't have to worry, cause it's working for me, yeah, it's working for me, yeah, it's working for me. Come on, sing that out, say that.
I don't have to worry,
it's working for me, yeah. It's working for me.
It's working for me.
I can hold my head up.
It's working
hey,
for me.
Get your confidence back. Sing, I don't have to worry. It's working for me.
Hey,
my faith is rising now.
It's working for me.
And although I can't see how,
it's working for me.
I know that he's intentional. Yes, he
he's intentional.
Doing it for a long time.
He's intentional.
Doing it for a long time.
He's intentional.
And I can give him my trust now.
He's intentional.
I can give him my praise now.
He's intentional.
worship you. I worship you. You are here working in this place. I worship you. I worship you. You are here moving in a mist. I worship you. I worship you. You are here working in this place. I worship you. I worship you. Hey, we make a miracle walker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. We make a miracle walker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. You are here touching every heart. I worship you. I worship you.
Can hear me, and I hope you guys can also see me. Me and Jacob was going through a little bit of lighting issues this morning. It just reminds me, I did a comedy thing for to raise some money for local food banks yesterday. It was Faison Love versus Michael Blackston. Faison gets on and says to Michael, he says, you so black that when God said, let there be light, you must have been out of town. So guys, I hope that you guys can hear me, and I also hope that you guys can also see me this morning. So our call to worship is going to come from Deuteronomy. It's going to be chapter 31, verse 6. And I'm going to be reading to you from the New International Version. And the word of the Lord reads, be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or terrified because of them. For the Lord your God goes with you, and he will never leave you nor forsake you. Now, this morning, somebody woke up. The Lord never left you nor forsook you. This morning, somebody had food on their table. The Lord never left you nor forsook you. You know, I was just thinking about the laugh that I had, you know, yesterday. You know, I hadn't laughed in a long time because of all of the terrible stuff that we're going through right now. But I'm here just to give you guys a little bit of encouragement this morning that the Lord will never forsake you, and he will never leave you. Amen. All right, let us pray. Dear Lord, we just want to thank you this morning for allowing us to come together in your presence once again, Father God. We thank you for all that you're doing for us in our lives and everything that you've done, Father God. You didn't have to wake us up this morning, but you did, and we just want to say thank you. You didn't have to do the little things that you do for us, Lord God, and we just want to say thank you this morning, Father God. Bless the message this morning, Father God, and bless the messenger that's going to be bringing the message this morning, Father God. Bless all the members of New Life Christian Ministries Church, Lord God, and bless all that are under the sound of my voice, Father God. And we thank you and we praise you in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. All right. Now, our ministry highlights. Welcome to all visitors, and thanks for worshiping with us. Ministry highlights and updates. Prayer request. You may now enter your prayer request online by giving at nlcmarietta.com/prayer request, and the prayer request will be sent directly to Pastor Taylor. The request received before Sunday will be forwarded to the head of the prayer ministry, and we as a church will cooperatively pray during Sunday service. Requests that are personal and confidential and for the pastor only will not be forwarded nor shared with others. For these, make sure you specify pastor only in the in your prayer request. All right, giving and COVID-19. If you're currently giving your tithes and offering by check, please consider changing online giving. Otherwise, the check may be a delay for your check to be cleared. With online giving, you can give by credit or debit card and your bank account, the electronic check. Give online. You are now able to give your tithes and offering, etc. online. Go to nlcmarietta.com to establish your profile. And once your profile is given, method is established, you will be able to give your from your browser or by texting 770-830-3332. Food pantry. The New Life Food Pantry is still open on the second and fourth Thursday of the month at 6 p.m. and 7 p.m. Patrons will no longer be able to select their own food items due to the CDC guidelines. You may still donate towards the food bank through online giving at nlcmarietta.com or donate non-perishables by contacting Brother Alistair directly. Free Family Renewal Enrichment Evening. Each family is encouraged to make Thursday evenings at 7:30 p.m. Your special time of prayer and togetherness. If this time does not work for you, select a time that is convenient for your family. Each family is encouraged to come together at this time and sharing and discussing and prayer. For the focus scripture this Thursday, April 30th, it would be Ephesians 5 and 21. also 6 and 1 through 9. Discuss the topic, life in a Christian household. And now we'll hear some remarks from the pastor.
I'm sorry, you may not have heard me. I was muted and I keep forgetting to unmute myself. And by the way, I don't see any video all neither, Brother Jacob, if you can correct that. But what I was saying is, I hope that life is finding you well and that everything is all right. The COVID-19, the one thing that changed last week that was major is that Georgia opened up some businesses, and that included churches, to begin gathering again. I thought about this carefully, and I've decided that this is not the time nor the place for us at this time. So we're going to keep on worshiping online. Amen. And what we need to keep in mind that we desire, I don't know about you, but I strongly desire for the time which we can meet together. That is a desire, but what we need and what we truly need is to continue our worship to our God in spirit and in truth, even though we may not be in the same physical place. So I hope that we can fulfill that need to continue worship, and one day we shall be together, but I don't think this is the time or the place yet. I don't know how long it will be, but I estimate at least 3 more weeks when we can see the trends going down. Then maybe we can start modifying our worship service to get some people into church. But I'm concerned about your health, and I'm concerned about your safety. So that is why I made the decision. If anybody want to talk to me about that offline, you may give me a call. And again, I sent this information in an email to everyone I had an email address for. So if you did not receive my email, please text me or email me at alton.taylor@att.net. The other thing I just want to emphasize, just in case you missed it, there's now an online prayer line. If you go to the nlcmarietta.com website, and you'll see it in the navigation bar, prayer, and you can put in a prayer request. And we do have one this morning. I just want to mention it just in case I forget it. It's really two from Sister Kathy. She put a request in for Shalanda and for Shaniqua. Shalanda, keep her in prayer. Keep the Baskerville family in prayer because they lost a grandmother to the COVID-19 virus. And if you remember, it was only a few weeks ago that she asked her to pray for the grandmother's granddaughter. So that's two in a family that have been affected. So we want to keep Sister Shalanda lifted up in prayer, and also keep Sister Shaniqua lifted up in prayer. Her grandmother also died, but she's sick. She's in the hospital with the COVID-19 virus. So just keep them up. And please take use of the prayer line and all the requests that we get prior to Sunday morning. I will forward to Sister Erica and she will include those. But I also encourage you to continue to use, you may continue to use the chat when we go into prayer near the end of service. And the final thing I want to say is, I just want to remind you or encourage you to use Give Online and not send checks or try to get cash to the church. Because if you send checks, it may not be picked up for a week because, you know, most of us are, kind of confined to our home. So the Give Online has proven to be very reliable. So if you can, and you can do it by check, even with Give Online, we've taken directly out of your bank account versus a credit card or a debit card. So I encourage you to do that. And may God bless you, and may we have a wonderful service. Amen.
everyone. It is Sister Alethea, and I have a treat for you today. I'm going to introduce you to one of my new friends. His name is Douglas, and Douglas is here to tell us about joy. So I want you guys to look at Douglas and listen carefully and hear what he has to say about the fruit of the Spirit, joy. Here's Douglas.
I've got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart. Hey guys, it's me again, Douglas, and today we're going to be talking again about the fruit of the Spirit. Yeah, and the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. And today we're going to be talking about joy. Now, joy is pretty much just happiness. Yeah, joy and happiness are pretty much the same thing. But there's a big difference between just normal kind of happiness and happiness that comes from the Holy Spirit, the happiness that comes from God. So, for example, if I'm going to have an ice cream cone, that makes me happy. That gives me joy until my ice cream cone is gone, and then I'm sad. But, like, I've got this friend, and his name is Brandon, and I really like him a lot. We have lots of fun. But he had to move far away, so I don't get to see Brandon very much anymore. But the other day, a little while ago, he came back into town, and I knew he was coming back into town, and the whole day I was happy because Brandon was coming. And you know what? That happiness could not be stopped. Mm-mm. No, I was happy all day. So I was helping in the nursery at church, and a kid literally bit me on the leg and stole my shoe. And I was like, ow, hey, give me my shoe back. But you know what? I wasn't mad. I was still happy because I was going to see Brandon that day, and it was so much fun. And actually, later on that day, I stepped in a puddle. Same shoe, actually. I stepped in a puddle, and it got all soggy and nasty and gross, but I didn't care. I just splashed around in the puddle because Brandon was coming. It was a great, great day. I was so excited he was coming, and then when he did come, we played board games. It was awesome. Pretty much the only thing that could have ruined my mood is if Brandon, for some reason, did not get to come. You know, maybe his flight got canceled, or he got in a car accident or something. Something would stop him from coming to see me. But you know what? If you get your joy, if you get your happiness from God, from the Holy Spirit, from the fact that you get to be with God every day, that you get to talk to the creator of the universe, that God himself came and died for your sins. He loves you that much. If your happiness comes from God, then your happiness is invincible. It can't be stopped. No. Somebody could spit right in your face and call you a dummy, but it doesn't matter because God loves you. You could step in some gum, but it doesn't matter because God loves you. You could even get thrown into prison or even killed. But you know what? It doesn't matter because God loves you. No one can take that away from you. No one can take God away from you. And so if you've got the Holy Spirit in your heart, it's there for good. No one can change that. So if your joy comes from God, your joy cannot be stopped. Now, I'm not saying that it's never okay to be sad. Jesus was sad. Jesus cried in the Bible. There's a time where he cried because everybody was sad. But even his sadness could not stop his joy because he knew what was coming next. And so do we. So my hope is that you would find your joy in God. Because when your happiness, when your joy comes from God, it can never be beat. God wants us to be joyful, and I hope that when people look at you, that they see joy.
Hey, it's Sister Alethea again. I hope you all enjoyed the message that our new friend Douglas gave us about joy. And now is an opportunity for everybody to sing along. Now, I don't know if all the kids in Children's Church know this song. So parents, while you're here, sing along with the VeggieTales and help them learn this song about joy.
I got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart.
Huh?
Down in my heart. I got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart to stay. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I have the love of Jesus in my heart. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I have the love of Jesus in my heart.
heart.
Where?
Down in my heart to stay. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I have the love of Jesus in my heart. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I have the love of Jesus in my heart.
Messiah that manifests miracles down in the depths of my heart.
Where?
Down in the depths of my heart.
Where?
Down in the depths of my heart. I've got the mighty Messiah that manifests miracles down in the depths of my heart.
Where?
Down in the depths of my heart
to stay. And I'm so happy, so very happy.
Sunday morning songs are like Sunday school songs, and not regular school songs.
That's right.
Too bad. I have a great song about fractions.
A song about what?
Fractions. You know, like 3/4 or 1/3. It goes like this. He's got 4/4 of the world. In his hands, he's got 3/3 of the world. In his hands, he's got 2/2 of the world.
Wait, Larry, hold it, hold it. Isn't 4/4, 3/3, and 2/2 of the world the same as the whole world?
That's right.
Well, then why not sing it this way?
Hey, Let the church say amen. Let me say that again. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Whether you are in your living room, dining room, kitchen, or whatever, let the church say amen. Whether you have combed your hair this morning, whether you have on a suit, or whether you sitting around home in a t-shirt, let the church say amen. For this is the day that the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and be glad in it. And I was glad when they said to me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Now, the way times are today, the house of the Lord is going to have to be your living room, your dining room, your kitchen, your bedroom, your bathroom, wherever you reside right now. But child of God, you know this, you have Jesus with you, and you have the power to uplift him, to praise his holy name, to worship him in spirit and truth, no matter where you are. So again, I say, let the church say amen, and let us all just touch and agree, even if we are experiencing social distancing, we can still touch and agree that God is worthy to be praised. I don't want to hold you long today, but for some reason, I feel like preaching today. I don't want to hold you long because I know the attention span sometimes on the internet when you're online can be a little distracting. But I promise you, I'll try to make it interesting and I'll try to make it applicable, so that you won't get distracted and get bored and go away. Amen. Let the church say amen. Wherever y'all, I believe you're saying amen where you are. But to begin with, what I would like to do is I'd like to go back. I'd like to go back to when I was a little boy and following my mother around the grocery store. And they had this is back once upon a time ago when people actually used to carry change, like quarters and pennies and dimes and the like. It wasn't the debit cards back then. We used to actually have change. And so what used to happen as the supermarket is they had these little machines, and inside the machines there'd be such things as gumballs, candies, little toys and trinkets. And one thing that I would always see during that time were these little dispensers called Pez candies. Now, I used to beg my mama to get those Pez candies, and every now and then, she would bless me with the opportunity to get one of those Pez candies. And so, if you're able, I pray that you're able, go ahead and look at the screen at those Pez candies, because those Pez candies, the way that they were made is they were a big, long strip. And inside the bar of the strip, there was candy inside there. And then to get to the candy, you had to flip open the top of the head of the thing and then shake it out in your mouth. And you have a Pez and get dispensed one candy at a time. So that's a Pez. And you're going to see in a moment why that is so appropriate to today's message. But to get started further, I'd like to share with you some goings on in my life that has taken place during this COVID-19 period of time that we find ourselves in. One of the things I decided to do personally was, since I'm at home and I can't go anywhere and not much I can actually do, I said this would be a good time that I could participate in some personal growth and development for some things in my life. You see, there's some software that I use frequently that I could read up on and watch some YouTube videos on and become a little bit more proficient with that software. There are some new skills that I could acquire and new tips and tricks that I could acquire to make my workflow more efficient. During this time, I got the time to do it. Might as well look at it. You know, I even decided to research some Bible study software the other day where I could, you know, find some software or something to kind of help me out as far as my sermon preparation and figure out a better workflow where I could work more easily in achieving the task that I wanted to achieve and in doing the task that I wanted to do. So I set out over these couple weeks to start doing that, and I'll sit down at the table and begin. But as I began to go on this journey of personal growth and development for these things in my life, I came across some pitfalls, as you might say. See, one of the pitfalls that I discovered is that even though I'm looking to do something new and in a new and better way, I found that I'm kind of used to doing things the way I'm used to doing them. I kind of like my old ways of doing things. They are familiar and comfortable. So many times I find myself resistant to the new things that come about. Another thing that I found is that the process can be a bit difficult. As a matter of fact, it's more difficult than I had initially anticipated. What I find is that in order to get to and achieve my goal of growth, there's this discipline that needs to take place. But when I'm sitting in my kitchen, when 10 feet away from me, there's some potato chips, when that same 10 feet away, I can get to the stove and find something to eat. When my wife is sitting next to me and I can have a quick conversation with her about something. When my daughter's in the other room and I listen to her beautiful voice as she practices her singing. What happens is I get distracted. My mind wanders. I go off into these other things. So that one of the pitfalls that I find is that there is a certain discipline that I have yet to achieve in order to reach these goals in the location where I am trying to achieve them. You know, sometimes I wish that my brain could be like mechanically be like one of those Pez candies that I talked about in the beginning, where you could just flip my head open, pour in all the knowledge that I needed and close it back up, and I'd have everything that I needed to achieve what I wanted to achieve. You know, better than that Pez dispenser, I can imagine it being something like The Matrix. Do y'all remember that movie that came out in the 90s, The Matrix? Well, if you don't remember it, we're going to get a little refresher of The Matrix real quick. So go ahead and play that video of The Matrix.
Can you fly that thing?
Not yet.
Operator.
Tank, I need a pilot program for a B-212 helicopter. Hurry.
Let's go.
Now that's what I'm talking about. That's learning right there. I could just forget flipping over, open my head, just download it into my brain, and I got it, and I'm ready to go. I want to fly a helicopter, just download how to fly a helicopter in the brain, and I got it. Boy, wouldn't that be great if we could have everything that we needed for personal growth and development just downloaded into our head and have access to it immediately. Well, that's a dream. Because unfortunately, it does not work like that. So how does it work? Well, we're going to explore personal growth and development, but we're going to take it one step further. We're going to add spiritual growth and development. And in order to take a look at that, we're going to go into the book of James. We're going to go into the book of James, first chapter, starting at verse 2. And it reads as follows. And I was so happy when Children's Church came on and Sister Alethea started playing the songs there. Because one of the things that I was looking for a rendition of I've Got the Joy, 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 Joy Down in My Heart. And look at there with the Veggie Tales and Brother Doug. I think I went to school with Doug's father, by the way. But Brother Doug came out. I think that was his name. Whatever his name was, blessed us with that. So it was good. I didn't have to find that. But on to the book of James. James chapter 1, starting at verse 2, begins as follows. My brethren, count it all joy when you fall into various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. But let patience have its perfect work, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing. If any of you lacks wisdom, let him ask of God, who gives to all liberally and with all and without reproach, and it will be given to him. But let him ask in faith with no doubting. For he who doubts is like a wave of the sea, driven and tossed by the wind. For let not that man suppose in that he will receive anything from the Lord. He is a double-minded man, unstable in all his ways. The passage of Scripture is an example that Christians can use to manage some expectations in terms of their personal spiritual growth. And I have news for you today, New Life. Today is your lucky day. Today is your lucky day because this passage of Scriptures does not just pertain to those Christians way back when and way back then. It is applicable today. It is applicable in today's time. In other words, this message is for you. So let's consider God's action plan for your spiritual development. And in considering these passages, we will be observing the following. First, recognize the need for spiritual growth. Secondly, see how faith relates to our spiritual growth. Thirdly, we'll examine the discipline of patience. And lastly, rejoice in the prospect that God will supply all of our needs. So let's move on to step one. Step one in our spiritual growth action plan: recognizing that we need improving. And to expound on this idea, I want to take you back about 10 years ago. You see, about 10 years ago, I worked for this company in Kennesaw. A few of my family members also worked at this company. And during my stay at this company, one thing that happened to me that can be thought of as kind of strange is I went through a whole lot of managers. Now, during that time, I did basically the same job, but I went through a whole lot of managers that managed me doing the same job, but each and every manager had different messaging, and a different set of expectations. And there was a great amount of inconsistency during that time. During my second, it was during the time period during my second to last manager that I had that I want to talk more specifically about. And for the sake of this message and for the sake of privacy, we will just refer to the manager's name as Elrond Megatron Smith. Let me say that again. I said his name was Elrond Megatron Smith, or we can call him EMS for short. And just so you don't think me too strange, some of y'all know what Easter eggs are. So I'm going to try to hashtag sermon Easter egg. You can look it up later. Elrond Megatron Smith and see how it relates to what I've been talking about so far. So you movie buffs will enjoy that. But anyway, on to the story. EMS, Elrond Megatron Smith. You know, I didn't care much about EMS's ways or his ways of management, so to speak. You see, my first encounter with EMS was within 30 days of him being assigned to the team that I was on. And within those 30 minutes, he proceeded to fire the young lady who was sitting next to me. And the way that she got fired was there was no warning. It's just security swooped in behind her, told her to get up and get her things and get out the building. And not that she did not deserve it, but the part that struck me about Mr. EMS was that he seemed to revel and take joy in the fact that he had caused this young lady a level of distress. This public humiliation in front of all these people to get walked out at that particular time within 30 minutes of him getting assigned to the team. What I also found about EMS is that that was not an isolated incident. You see, through the next few weeks and then months, what Mr. EMS proceeded to do was hack away at the team. He would find any and every reason to complain, to criticize, to talk about all the stuff that we weren't doing right, but never offer solutions on as to how to improve, or never offer any coaching or things like that. So little by little, the team started to dwindle down, and it seemed as if each time someone would get fired, he would take pleasure and joy that someone else had gotten fired. As a matter of fact, on one occasion, I remember him stating that, I'll make sure all of y'all get fired before I get fired for not firing you, for not having the numbers that you're supposed to have. So needless to say, the atmosphere was not a very good one on Mr. EMS's team. He would embarrass people at the little circle meetings and publicly just ridicule and criticize. And again, never offer solutions for how we could improve. One day, it became my turn to meet with Mr. EMS. For some reason, he decided to have a one-on-one with me that one day. And to my surprise, it was a good meeting. We talked, we discussed. He had printed out a copy of, he had photocopied a sheet of paper with some pointers and tips on some things that would help me. And as I went back to my desk, I found myself smiling. Wow, you know, that wasn't so bad. I said, maybe I had him wrong. Maybe I'm doing all right. I've got some coaching now, and this is going to help me out. Well, Within about 10 minutes, Mr. EMS came over to my desk with another piece of paper, and he asked me to sign this one, and I said, yes, I signed it. And as I gave it back, I suddenly realized I just got written up. I said, oh my goodness, this man just wrote me up on the down low, on the sly, had no idea that it was coming, and I just signed the write-up. And he told me afterwards, he said, you got 2 weeks or else your job is in jeopardy. Needless to say, I found myself in a situation that I did not want to be in. I felt like I was a target or the next target of this man's hacking away. My brothers and sisters, have you ever found yourselves in one of life's trials? Have you ever found yourself in a difficult situation, in one of those, I don't know what to do. I don't know how to do it. I don't know the next step to take. Have you found yourself in one of life's position where it seems like there are people who are trying to come against you from each and every side, and you feel the pressure that is being brought about by these people, and you feel like you may not have control over that situation? My brothers and my sisters, I'm here to let you know that there are indeed not just people, not just situations and circumstances, but there are principalities and wickedness in high places that will inevitably try to come against you just for the mere fact that you call yourself a child of God. And let's not forget the natural occurrences which may come about. Sickness, disease, all of these things are here. And if you're not careful, they will steal your joy, steal your peace. And no one is immune from these things coming about in your life. So what should our response be to all of these things that come about? Well, as we grow spiritually, our response should be to draw closer to God. And as we grow spiritually, our response should be that if we come into line with what God would desire us to do, then we'd be able to get through. But let's just see what the Bible says about this. We've already read it. But the Bible says in James 1 verse 2, my brethren, count it all joy when you fall into various trials. To put it plainly, God tells us to count it all joy. Count it as good. Count it as good for me. In other words, let's take the situation, take the circumstance, and let's flip the focus from the situation and the circumstance that is at hand, and resist the temptation to wallow in that, but instead do something that is contrary to our very human nature, that in the face of a situation, in the face of a trial, in the face of a temptation, in the face of adversity, instead of wallowing in sadness and sorrow and fear and suffering, we should count it all joy. Flip it around. Count it all joy. take access of the joy that God has already given through his Holy Spirit. Take access of the joy that God gave you once you became a child of God. It's there. You don't always feel like it's there, but guess what? You have access to it. That's the very reason that, that God can say, count it all joy. He already gave you access to the joy. It's just a matter of realizing that the joy is there and you taking hold of it. And again, recognizing that this may be hard, but this is for my good. You see, what I'm, you got to recognize the situation that you're going through right now. There's some growth that's getting ready to take place. There's some things that are getting ready to happen in your life. Realize that what you are getting ready to experience through these trials and tribulations are a manifestation of God's spiritual growth action plan for your life. And if you recognize that and flip it on its end and recognize that God is getting ready to grow me spiritually through this, take access of that joy which God has already given and count the situation joy. Mm-hmm. Step number two. God's spiritual growth action plan or in God's spiritual growth action plan, you are going to need some faith. Simply put, faith is believing that God is who he says he is and that God will do what he says that he will do. You see, faith allows us to ask God, trust in his response, and believe that his plan is greater. Let me say that again. Faith allows us to ask God, trust in his response, and believe that his plan is greater. James 1, 5 through 8 says as follows. If any of you lacks wisdom, let him ask of God, who gives to all liberally and without reproach, and it will be given to him. But let him ask in faith with no doubting, for he who doubts is like a wave of the sea, driven and tossed by the winds. For let not that man suppose that he will receive anything from the Lord. For he is like a double-minded man, unstable in all his ways. You see, God wants us to have faith in him. God wants us to trust him. But not just that, God wants us to ask him, trust him, and believe in him. Believe that he is who he says he is, and he will do what he says that he will do. You see, God is willing and able to give, but we have to be willing and able to ask. Amen? God is willing and able to meet our needs, but we have to be willing and able to trust this process that God will take in order to give us not just what we want, but what we actually need. God is willing and able to deliver. But we have to believe in his love for us, that he would not leave us or forsake us. And we must resist the doubt, the fear, the emotions that are brought about by trials. We have to remember that what he did back then, guess what? He can do it again. We have to remember that what he did for Sister Sue and Sally, guess what? He could do the same for us, same God. step three in the action plan. Let's move on. You got to have patience. One of my mother's phrases that she likes to bring up a lot is when my daughter was little, I think they were baking or something, and she told my mother, "You got to have patience, Mama too. You got to have patience." And so my mother will say that from time to time. Guess what, church? You got to have patience. You have to have patience. James verse 1:3-4 says, "But let patience," or I'm sorry, says, "knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. But let patience have its perfect work, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking
this is fire."
You know, there's a saying that you have to spend money to make money. Well, I'm here to tell you today that you have to partake of the patience that God has given you, the Holy Ghost patience that God has given you, to grow the patience and let it manifest itself in your life and increase your faith. The pitfalls many of us come about is we get antsy. We think that God's not moving fast enough. We think that we get tired of waiting on God. We get tired of the situation. We get where we like, "God, you got to move right now." And God may not yet. But the pitfall we fall into is we try to take over and drive and start doing God's work for him. And inevitably, what happens is when we take over, what do we learn in that situation? Because there's still going to be some growth that's going to take place. But what we learn, at least in my life, what I learned is, Lord, I done figured out, I done learned what not to do when I'm trying to do your job, when I'm trying to take over and do what you have the ability, power, and capability to handle and do, I try to do. So we have to have patience and wait on God and learn and trust God. And as we learn and wait and watch God move, what happens is our faith is increased because we get that situation where we saw God do it and we experience it and we see how God does it better than what we had laid out in our head. But to get patience, you got to have patience. Let's move on to step four, obtaining wisdom. By going through trials, we gain insight and experience. As a matter of fact, we experience firsthand God's nature. We experience his ability. We experience his power, his love, his grace, his mercy, his knowledge. We gain wisdom. And wisdom allows us to recognize that we may be going through, and there may be trials and tribulations, but wisdom allows us to recognize that I'm at a new level, and because I'm at this new level, it's going to bring about a new devil. But with that wisdom, we can go back and go through our mind's memory as to what happened before in that last trial and that last situation. And what it allows us to do is grab hold of that arsenal of faith that has been building. And we have the weapons to effectively fight. Wisdom allows us to dig into that faith arsenal and speak the words of God and proclaim that no weapon formed against me shall prosper. Wisdom allows us to go back in that faith arsenal and proclaim God's word. proclaiming that he who is in me is greater than he who is in the world. Going through strengthens our relationship with God, which in turn hardens our resolve to keep on following, to keep on keeping on, to keep on trusting, to not give up, to not waver, not to have that double-minded man type of faith that God's word talked about. But we go, in all this, we can go back to the beginning. We can start at the basics. The basics is, you have to be willing to go through the process. You have to be willing to let God mold and mend you and make you into the person that he wants you to be and that he desires you to be. So that starts with a willing heart, a trusting heart, a heart of gratitude, a heart of thankfulness. And what better way to thank somebody, or better yet, thank God? What better way to thank him than to praise him? And to follow the words that he says, to follow his word, to follow his guidance, to follow his direction. To be willing to go through those trials and situations, not murmuring and complaining, but to count it all joy, knowing that God is working on you, that God is working on your life, that this situation that you're going through is not always, and God forbid, if this be your last trial, your last situation, and that you find yourself at the end of your life, that when you wake up, hallelujah, child of God, you will wake up in glory. You will wake up at the right hand of your Father. You will wake up with a glorified body. You will wake up with the ultimate spiritual growth, being better than you were before. But until that day comes, when you get there, know that you will be tried. Know that you will be tested. But God calls us to count it all joy. And not only that, he doesn't call us to count it all joy. He has given us the ability to take hold of that joy. He has given us the patience to endure through it. And not only that, child of God, he has said, ask. What do you need? Do you need it? Do you need wisdom? Ask. Do you need patience? Ask. Do you need to learn to love your neighbor? Ask. What do you need? Do you need to kind of a way to get through, to keep in your right mind? Ask. Do you need a little bit of extra infusion to keep you going on through the day? Ask. Know that he will give you what you need when you need it. And that he is able, he has all power, and he is willing to do it. Because he loves you. He cares for you. You are important to him. You matter to him. Count it all joy, y'all. During this time of difficulty, count it all joy. During this time of trouble around us in our land, count it all joy. And rejoice in God's work. Amen.
I've got so much to thank God for. So blessings and so many open doors. praise you
for this.
Good afternoon, New Life. I'm not sure if you can hear me or not. Okay. Yep, you can hear me. Amen. So good afternoon. Thank you so much, Reverend Dana, for that wonderful message reminding us of the steps that we need to take for further spiritual growth. And that in all that, we are to count it all joy when we find ourselves in diverse temptations and testings of our faith. That is a very appropriate message, especially for the time and place that we find ourselves. One of the things that Reverend Dana mentioned in the message that I just want to expound upon just for a few seconds is the reminder that he gave us, encouragement that he gave us to ask whether we needed faith To ask God for more faith if we need more faith, to ask for more patience if that's what we stand in need of. If we need wisdom, you know, to ask for those things. And that stood out for me because another scripture that came to mind as he was preaching is, we have not because we ask not. So many times I believe that for us believers, sometimes we miss out on some of the basic things that God wants us to have, not because God is not willing to provide it to us, but because we fail just to ask for the things that we stand in need of. So this is just an encouragement. Of course, we're going to pray this afternoon, but you know, in your own time, if there's something that you stand in need of, ask God. So many things that I used to take for granted, small things that I didn't want to bother God about because, you know, he's such a big God and there's so many things going on in the world. And so these small things that, you know, I have to burden myself through, I'm not going to burden those with God with those small things because they're so minor things. But what I've learned in fellowship and in relationship with God is that God wants me to carry even those small things to him, those small requests that I may have, those small desires of my heart that I may have. I can take those things to God and trust him with it. And what I've been blessed in just seeing him work time and time again, even in those small things that I previously didn't want to bother him with. Now I try to bombard heaven with all those things. So if it comes up, I try to ask God and give those things to God. So the encouragement today, as Reverend Dana mentioned in the message, ask those for those things that we stand in need of. To that end, we're going to go into prayer. So if you want to put your prayer requests in the chat function, Reverend Pastor Taylor did mention Sister Shalonda and Sister Geneva. Sister Shalonda did lose her grandmother this week, and Sister Geneva's mother is in the hospital. So we certainly will keep them in prayer. And I see another request to pray for Bree Anna, whose baby is due in September. Pray for healthy mom and baby and also resources as needed and opportunities and field that she wants to work in. Amen. We'll certainly keep that in prayer. So you can continue to put your request in. I will go ahead and go to the throne and start. But if there's something else that is in your heart that we should pray for, please make sure that you put it in the chat function and I'll look up and we'll pray for those things as well. So let's go to the throne. Let's go to the one who can do something about the things that we stand in need of. Heavenly Father, we just are so grateful to you today, Lord. We just thank you, number one, for being God. We thank you, Lord, for the fact that you sit on the throne. We thank you, Lord God, that even now you hear our prayers, Lord God. You know the burdens of our heart, Lord. You know our requests, Lord. You know the things that we struggle with and the things that we stand in need of and the things that we go through, Father. And for that, Lord God, we just say thank you. We thank you, Lord, that you are so intimately familiar with us that you know the number of hairs that we have on our head. You know the words that we speak even before we speak them. Your word says that you know when we sit down and when we rise, Father God. And for that, Lord, we're thankful that you're so intimately familiar with us, that you know everything that concerns us, Lord. We just thank you, Father God, for being God. We thank you that you are in control of all things, Lord, that you know all things and you see all things, Father. And for that today, Lord God, we just say thank you, Father. We thank you that, you know, even though we're all at home, Lord, social distancing, Lord God, we thank you that even in this pandemic, Lord, your hand has been strong, Lord. We thank you for all of those that have recovered, Lord God, all of those family members that are able to celebrate, Lord God, recovery of those that have gotten sick, Lord God. We just thank you for providing healthcare workers, Lord God, to work through the pandemic, Lord. We just thank you even for the government officials, Lord, some who we may not agree with the decisions that they're making, Lord God, but we thank you, Lord God, that people are in place to help with things as we stand in need, Father. And we're so grateful to you today, Lord. In the midst of all that, Lord God, there are things that we do stand in need of, Lord. I'm asking right now for comfort for Sister Shalonda's family, Lord God, for Sister Shalonda and her family, Lord, that is mourning the loss of their grandmother that did not survive. And Father God, we just pray comfort and healing for that family. We just pray that you would envelop them right now in your love, Lord. We pray that you would use this always as a catalyst to draw your people closer to you, Father God. Help this to cause people not to turn away from you, Lord God, but to turn toward you, Father, knowing that you alone are God, knowing that the path that grandmother took, Lord God, we all must go one day, Father. And I just pray that you would use this, Father God, to draw your children closer to you. Lord, we ask that you just bless Geneva's grandmother as well, who's also sick. And we're praying for healing, Lord God, not just for her grandmother, Lord God, but for all of the people, Lord, that are all across the country, all over the world, Lord God, that may find themselves sick right now, Lord, battling something that their body doesn't have the immunity to be able to fight, Lord. We just pray for a supernatural immunity, Lord. We just plead the blood of Jesus over all of the workers in the hospital, Lord God, that you would guide their hands, Lord. We plead the blood of Jesus on all of those that are sick, Lord God, on all of those that are struggling, whether it be with COVID-19 or something else, Father God. We're just asking, Lord, that you be the healer that we know you are, Father God. And we ask for recovery, Lord God. We pray for testimonies, Lord, of people who thought that they weren't going to make it, Lord God, but by your grace, they made it. And we pray, Lord, that they will testify to your goodness and to your greatness. We just thank you for that today in the name of Jesus. We ask that you just bless Brianna, Father. And we just pray for a healthy baby, Lord God. We pray that you just would keep her healthy, Lord God, and give her what she needs, make provision for her, Father God, open doors of opportunity that need to be opened. We just cast Brianna and baby as a care to you, Lord God, and we just trust you to take care of them, Lord. We ask that you bless a young lady in Macon who was killed earlier this morning, who was 8 months pregnant. Who both she and the baby were killed. Lord, we just pray for the family right now, Lord God. We pray for comfort for the family, Lord. We just pray that we don't know the circumstances or situation behind this death, Lord, but we know that you know all things, Lord God. And we're just asking, Father, for comfort for that family, for provision for all the other family members that she might have been impacting, Lord, or providing for, taking care of, Father God. We just cast her as a care to you, Lord God, and we cast the family as a care to you today in the name of Jesus. Thank you. Yeah, we pray for Shaniqua and Shalonda's grandmother. And Father God, we know that there are other things that we may stand in need of, Father. I just pray that the body of Christ would call upon you more, Father God, that we would reach out to you more, that we would cast our cares upon you more, Lord God, in faith, trusting that you're able to do beyond that whatever we could ask or think. And you said it according to the power that worketh within us, Father God. Give us the grace during this time, Lord God, to seek your face more, to focus on spiritual growth and development, Lord God, to reach out to one another, Lord God, to encourage one another, Father God. And to draw near to you, Father God, we just thank you that you are working all things out according to, for our good, Lord God, according to your divine and perfect plan. And for that, we just say thank you, Lord God. We thank you for giving us peace in the midst of whatever the things that we're going through right now, Father God. We pray that as we stay at home and social distance, we're finding ways of connecting with our families in new and different ways and working on projects and things, Lord God, that maybe we have been putting off, Father. And we just thank you so much, Lord God, for even in this, Lord, we can count it all joy, knowing that our tests and the trials of our faith are growing patience within us. And when patience has had her perfect work, Lord God, we will be complete, lacking nothing. And for that, Lord God, we just say thank you. We cast all these things as cares to you. And we ask all these things in Jesus' name. One more prayer. Prayer for K Kenda and Laquanda, who work at the hospital. Lord God, we just pray for Kenda specifically and Laquanda. We plead the blood of Jesus over them. We pray that you would cover them, protect them, Lord God. Put a shield all about them, Lord, to prevent them from getting the virus that they may be exposed to right now, Lord. We just pray that you would arm them and equip them with whatever it is that they need, Lord God, to be effective. As they provide care for patients, Lord, we just pray for peace for the mama right now, Lord God, that she won't be worried about her children, Lord God, and where they're working right now, but that she would be prayerful and cast them as cares to you and trust you to take good care of them, Lord God. We just thank you for all these things. In Jesus' name, amen.
That's why when every connection counts, you can count on us.
Subaru has always valued safety. At Subaru of Kennesaw, we're open for business, while working to keep every...
And let the church say amen. Let's give Reverend Dana a hand for that.
Enter a house. Enjoy 0% financing for 63 months on...
Let this church say amen. I don't hear anything, so I'm not sure whether Reverend Dane is available to give the benediction or not. So I will. So will you please bow with me as I give you the benediction? Let us pray. Our Father God, we thank you for being with us this day. God, we thank you for your presence, God. We continue to ask, God, that you just give us, let us feel your presence, God, as we go through the days that are before us, God. God, we pray that you help us remember those things that you have promised us, God, that we learn to walk in those things. God, we pray that you will help us to keep in mind that you are always with us. You will never leave us nor forsake us, God. And God, we will pray that you keep us, God, until we are able to meet again. In the name above every name, that the children of God say amen. Amen and amen. May God bless you until we meet again. In Jesus' name, amen.